Hello and welcome back. Let's move on and implement our register page now. We have a login page that's looking half decent. In the last lesson, we did create that register.html file, but if we take a look in our browser, it's just this basic test that we've put in there in that p tag. So let's get started and start writing out the HTML that we need to get this working. You can go ahead, and I think the easiest way is let's just copy all of our HTML that we've written in our index.html and then paste it into the register. My live server has like kind of frozen, so it's not updating the code changes that I make. This sometimes does happen. You can just try refresh the page, and if that's not working, you can just kill the server and then restart it, start like a new version. The changes have been applied. It just looks exactly like our login page because we've just copied the page over here. So let's get started implementing the changes we want here. So instead of saying enter your details to login, we can say something like register for the auth app. We have the email and passport inputs which we're going to be using in the register as well. If we remember, our register endpoint is going to require additional information, and that's going to be the first name and last name. So we can just copy out these the label and input elements, and then we can adjust them for the first name. So we'll just say this label is for first name. And then this is just going to be a simple text type. ID, we'll say first name. And then placeholder, we'll just give that first name. And we can adjust the same thing for the last name. So in the label, this type will also just be a simple text. The ID, again, we can just call that last name. And then placeholder here, we can say last name. And those will be all the inputs that we need. So that's all good. Let's change the name of our button here. We're going to call this register instead of login. And then instead of saying don't have an auth app account, we can say something like already have an account. And then instead of linking to the register page, we'll head back to the login page. And so with that, now we have got our register page, which we kind of just leveraged our work that we did with the login form. The same styling is being applied because we're using the same classes. So I think that's a convenient thing for us. We've got our email, password, first name, and last name fields. We've got our register button. And now we've got this way to toggle between the two different forms. And as I do that, I see I've made a mistake here. Obviously, we don't have a login.html. It's index.html. So that's my mistake. I'm just going to hit save there. And we can go back to the register. And what I was trying to demonstrate was if we click login, so obviously it hasn't applied the changes. So I'm just going to refresh here. And so once I hit login there, it's going to take us to the index.html file. So only got these two inputs. And if we click on register, it goes to the register page, then back to the login. So I think we've done some good work here. We set up all the HTML and styling that we need for our register and login page. The next task is going to be start implementing the profile page, which is going to be the page that's supposed to be behind the login form and the register form. The intention there is not to have it accessible to the public. So I think let's take a short break here. We've got the basic building blocks out the way. I'll see you in the next one. Cheers for now.